Hi there, my name is Sarah Reach, and I am the manager of rehabilitation and research, as well as the head veterinarian here at Willowbrook Wildlife Center. Willowbrook Wildlife Center is a facility that's been around for around 65 years, providing care to sick, injured, and orphaned wild animals native to DuPage County. Unfortunately, over the last few decades, if you will, we've seen more and more and more animals. And that's great, we continue to provide high quality care for these animals. Unfortunately, one of the biggest challenges we face right now is a lack of space. We've actually expanded our rehab space out into our visitor center, previously due to COVID, but now because we have rehab animals literally in our classroom, in our visitor center, in our resident animal rooms, basically everywhere spread out. One of the biggest things we've seen recently is a challenge with laundry. We're doing laundry, you know, 20 to 30 loads per day. And if one of those machines has some sort of issue, we get a backlog of laundry. One of our most commonly used rooms is our ICU room. And that room is really supposed to be there for our critical patients. Once we run out of space, we either have to move those animals to a completely different room where we may not be able to monitor them as closely, or we have to do something like stacking up carriers in that room. And while it still gives them appropriate medical care, it's not the appropriate housing for those animals. One of the biggest changes we want to see indoors is actually to separate predator and prey areas. Right now, we have rooms that have both predator and prey species right next to each other. So you could have a raccoon next to a herring gull, next to a red-tailed hawk, next to a cottontail bunny. And unfortunately for those prey species, that's gonna be highly stressful for those animals. So purely just keeping them separated into different rooms and actually different sides of buildings to keep sounds, smells, all of those things kind of separated out, it'll actually make the rehab process much more successful for those animals. So obviously a large part of this project is an expansion of the space, but actually what we want to do is make the space much more functional. Right now, we split up our rehab between two separate buildings, and a lot of that time is actually wasted moving back and forth and back and forth when it could be dedicated to animal care. So really when we look at kind of the structure of our both outdoor spaces and indoor spaces, they're going to be designed in a way where we have a much better flow. Not only are many of these changes going to greatly improve our animal welfare, our staff welfare, but honestly, many of them are going to improve our visitor experience. One of our biggest thoughts for this master plan is turning our visitor center into a window into wildlife rehabilitation. And so our exam room, our surgery room, multiple of our holding rooms will all have very large one-way glass windows where people, the visitors, can actually look in and see the experience. So they could come on one day and see a great horned owl baby get an exam. They could see a red-tailed hawk getting his wing wrapped from a fractured wing. They could walk next door and see a snapping turtle getting fishing hooks removed or a shell being fixed. They could take a step down and actually see 10, 20, 30 baby cottontails and screech owls and squirrels being fed. So they can see every single aspect of our rehabilitation process. And if you came in the next day, you could see a completely different subset of animals. And so it gives people a much better understanding of what goes on behind the scenes, and honestly, a much better ownership of the animals they bring in because they see how much goes into those animals being cared for. So having this master plan with an increased indoor and outdoor space allows us to basically stay with the times and become a nationally renowned facility.